Rock and roll used to be something that your parents warned you against, an alien sound that broke free of the society that created it and formed a world all its own. But as the 70s ended, that world had become integrated into popular culture, and rock could now be found in the checkout stand of the local supermarket. And to many, the music no longer mattered. But in England, at that same time, the working class frustrations that fired the greatest rock boiled over into what came to be known as the punk movement. And once again, the music became a threat. Bands like the Sex Pistols, the Damned, and most importantly, the Clash, took their music back into the streets and articulated a new dissatisfaction with the status quo. Of all the representatives of this movement, the Clash have proved to be the most durable, and their influence has crossed the Atlantic. We asked some of their fans what it is about the Clash and their music that is so compelling.
A lot of bands just sing about, you know, going to the teen hop or something. The Clash really has a lot of meaning.
I don't know what the hell they're talking about, but I like their music.
They talk about the revolution.
Now,
as long as you break things, the revolution is still going on. You just got to break big things.
The Clash's music is turbulent with the sounds of reggae wrapped around the roots of rockabilly. But Mick Jones, Joe Strummer, Paul Simonon, and Topper Heaton's music goes beyond influences, and their lyrics and on- and offstage personas make it obvious that there's more to the Clash than what meets the ear.
We are singing about things that maybe we should mean more to people, right? So they should take notice of the lyrics. But I mean, that's fair. I mean, you don't go to a concert, you can't hear the lyrics in our shows anyway, right? You can't hear nothing in our shows. When we play music, right? And that's what it is. And, you know, when we're on stage, it's nothing to do with politics at all.
Rock and roll.
Exactly.
Throughout their lyrics, images such as nuclear holocaust, famine, and political prisons abound. Depressing, to be sure, but an honest reaction to realities that are more frightening than even the sounds of rock and roll were to our parents.
I mean, it's right now, you know? I mean, it's Armageddon, man. I mean, who are you trying to kid?
Armageddon or not, here's The Clash doing what they do best, performing what turned out to be a top 40 single, Train in Vain.